the summer bang.
I'm back with a new video today and I am so excited for you guys to see this one. I worked really hard on it and I hope that you guys like it. If you're not already doing so, be sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter. I'll leave the name right here below. It's the same for both of them. That way you guys can stay in touch with me and be updated whenever I make a new video or if I'm thinking about making a new video, or you guys can give me ideas about what kind of video I should make. So for this video, if you couldn't already tell by the title, I will be showing you guys how to make your own dorm slash room decor, and it's super easy. All four of them are like so easy you won't even believe it. They all look really cute in the end and I'm just so excited to show you guys. So it's perfect for back to school. I know a lot of people like to make the room look a little bit different for a new school year, and it's even better if you make the things on your own. All your friends will come over to your room and be like, oh my gosh, where'd you get that? And you can be like, oh my gosh, I made it. So yeah, I don't really want to make this intro very long because I just want you guys to see the video, so let's get into the video.
You watch me bleed until I can't breathe, shaking, falling onto my knees, and now that I'm without your kiss.
So I found this idea on Pinterest and I absolutely love it because you can spice up any plain mirror to make it look a lot more unique.
Aching, begging you to come out.
You'll need a mirror, a hot glue gun, scissors, and fake flowers.
Just like a moth drawn to a flame. Oh, you lured me in, I couldn't sense the pain.
So what you want to start doing is cut all the stems off of all the flowers.
Now I'm gonna reap what I sow. I'm left seeing red on my own. Got a feeling that I'm going under, but I know that if I quit calling you my lover and move on. You watch me bleed until I can't breathe, shaking, falling onto my knees, and now that I'm without your kisses, I'll be needing stitches.
So once you've cut off all the stems from the flowers, start by rearranging how you would like your flowers to be on your mirror before you glue them so that you don't mess anything up.
I'll be needing stitches.
And then you can go ahead and start hot gluing them to the mirror.
Needle and the thread, gotta get you out of my head. Needle and the thread, gonna wind up dead. Needle and the thread, gotta get you out of my head.
So I'm just continuing the process by hot gluing all the flowers onto the mirror. And you can design it however you'd like. I chose to do the corners of the mirrors because that's just how I saw it on Pinterest and I thought it would work best for me. So I just continued this process with the other side of the mirror as well. This is the final product and I am so excited and so happy with how it turned out, and I am so excited to put it in my dorm this fall.
Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep but now we're stressed out.
This DIY is probably one of my favorites because Polaroids are in right now. All you're gonna need is a cork board. I purchased mine from Target. A foam poster board, I think that's what they're called. A hot glue gun, once again. An X-Acto knife. And a pencil. With your pencil, draw a line where you think you should cut the bottom of the poster board. I cut mine at 3 inches from the bottom. Then, taking your X-Acto knife, cut where your line was drawn, but make sure you have a cutting board underneath because it is very sharp. Then once it's cut, you can just gently take off the bottom piece of the poster board. Now to get the middle piece of the poster board cut out, you have to take the cork board and trace it. Then with your X-Acto knife again, just cut along the lines that you drew. And you should be able to punch that middle piece right out and it finally looks like a Polaroid.
To the good old days,
when the mama sings. Now, taking your corkboard, go ahead and place it into the middle. Once you've done that, hot glue the four edges of the corkboard to the poster board to be sure that it all stays together. When the mama sang us to sleep, but now we're stressed out. And if you think it's a little bit too plain, you can add any type of decoration you want to. I just added some flowers left over from the floral mirror that I did in the first DIY. Make money, yeah. We used to play pretend, give each other different. Now it's time for my favorite part, putting pictures onto the corkboard.
Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep.
Like I said before, this is probably one of my very favorite DIYs I have ever created. To the good old days.
Welcome to my house, baby, take control now.
Now it's time for some 3D wall art.
We don't have to go wild.
You will need a white canvas, the letter of your first name, a hot glue gun, spray paint, acrylic paint, and a circle sponge. I would definitely recommend doing this outside and to wear clothes that you don't mind getting dirty. So now it's time to spray paint your canvas any way that you'd like. I'm using pink and silver.
Close the blinds, let's
pretend. Now it's time to spray paint the J, which I'm going to spray paint all white.
Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne.
Now it's time to wait for them to dry, and once they have completely dried, it's time to decorate.
That's how we do. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in. Welcome to my house, baby, take control now.
Once you are done decorating your letter, you can go ahead and hot glue the letter to your canvas. And now you're done, and it'll tie your whole entire room together. For my last DIY, all I really did was spray paint a birdcage. Now all you're gonna need is a birdcage, which I'm pretty sure you can find at any craft store. I decided to paint mine pink because I'm absolutely in love with this color.
You got me all wrong, baby. My baby's already got all of my love.
And once you've spray painted it, all you're gonna have to do is wait for it to dry.
Baby, my baby's
pretty simple if you ask me.
So no, you're good.
So now that it's dry, you can take Instagram pictures with it or even put it in your room like a normal person would do, but I just think that it ties your room together completely and makes it look awesome.
So that's about it for this video. I hope you guys liked it, and if you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and leave a comment below which one of the DIYs was your favorite. So yeah, that's about it, and I will see you guys in my next video.
Bye, 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 bye.